फ्रेंड्स, माई सेल्फ मिस रचना जैन, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंग्लिश, गवर्नमेंट पीजी कॉलेज, राजगढ़, अलवर। टुडे इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू द पोएम डावर बीच, कंपोज्ड बाय मैथ्यू अर्नोल्ड, ए फेमस पोएट ऑफ विक्टोरियन एरा। दिस पोएम इज मैंशनड इन द सिलेबस ऑफ बी ए पार्ट थर्ड इंग्लिश लिटरेचर, पेपर फर्स्ट, यूनिट ए। दिस इज माई थर्ड वीडियो लेक्चर ऑन दिस पोयम। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई रीड यू द लाइन्स ऑफ दिस पोयम। लिसन, यू हियर द ग्रेटिंग रोयर ऑफ पेबल्स विच द वेव्स ड्रॉ बैक एंड फ्लिंग at their return up the high strand, begin and cease and then again begin with tremulous cadence, slow and bring the eternal note of sadness in. One night the poet is standing near the shore at the Dover beach. Moon is shining in the sky. Its light is falling over the whole Strait of Dover. The French coast is also shining dimly in the moonlight. The poet calls his beloved to come to the window and look at this beautiful sight. He wants that she may enjoy the sight of long line of water drops which arise as the waves fall on the white moonlit coast of the sea. He wants that she may also enjoy the sweet air blowing in the night. Now, I explain you the difficult words of the poem's lines in the simple language. Grating means harsh noise. Pebbles means round stones. Fling means throw. Tremulous cadence means trembling. Cadence means tone. Eternal note means permanent sound. Listen. The poet invites his beloved to come to the window to listen to the roaring sound of the waves attentively. You hear the grating roar of pebbles. He tells to his beloved that now at this time the sea is not calm. She can hear the harsh sound of the round stones in the waves of the sea. When the waves strike against the shore of the sea, then they produce the harsh sound. Which the waves draw back and fling at their return up the high strand. The poet means to say the rise and flow of the waves of the sea has started now. The waves rise and fall on the coast and they return back. When they rise, they throw the pebbles or round stones on the shore of the sea. When they return, the waters pass over the pebbles and produce a harsh sound. Begin and cease and then again begin with tremulous cadence slow. This ebb and flow, this rise and fall of the waves of the sea is creating a kind of trembling musical sound and bring the eternal note of sadness in, and it inspires sad thoughts about the world in the mind of the poet. So the poet asks his beloved to come to the window to listen to the roaring sound of the waves of the sea attentively. The sound of the waves tells of the rise and fall of human misery, as the poet tells us. It is eternal. It means that man has ever been a miserable creature throughout his life. So this sound, this ebb and flow, this rise and fall in the waves of the sea produces the sad thoughts in the mind of the poet. Sophocles long ago heard it on the Aegean, and it brought into his mind the turbid ebb and flow of human misery. We find also in the sound a thought, hearing it by this distant northern sea. Sophocles was a great Greek dramatist, 496 to 406 BC. Aegean is the name of the sea. Turbid means not clear or muddy or confused. Ebb and flow means rise and fall, the return of the tide. Misery means woes or sorrows and sadness. Now, I explain you the context of these lines. The poet is looking towards the sea from his window and sees the ebb and flow in the sea. The movement of the sea waves remind him of the rise and fall inside his mind. In these lines, the poet compares the sad condition of the present day man with the people living in the Greek period. Sophocles long ago heard it on the Aegean. The poet says that the Greek dramatist Sophocles also found himself in the same situation in which the poet finds himself in the late 19th century Europe. He says Sophocles heard the ebb and flow of the Aegean Sea 3,000 years back. When he saw the rolling waves, he was reminded of the turbulence of human faith. It brought into his mind the turbid ebb and flow means these rise and fall of the rolling waves reminded him the turbulence or disturbance of human faith. He was reminded the human life which is full of misery. We find also in the sound a thought, hearing it by the distant northern sea. The poet says that the tide and ebb can be compared to the cycle of life and death, happiness and misery of human life. Today, the poet hears the same sound while he is standing on the shore of the northern sea. Even today, his mind reflects on the human misery. So, in these lines, the poet says to his beloved that hearing the sound, Sophocles was reminded of the increase and decrease in man's miseries. Sometimes man becomes very miserable due to the physical illness or loss of his kith and kin. This is the flow of miseries. After some time, he feels a big relief of miseries. This is its ebb. But he is never perfectly happy. Soon again the miseries increase. When Arnold hears the roaring sound at Dover Beach, he is reminded of the loss of man's religious faith. So he is very sad to hear the roaring sound of the waves of the sea standing by the shore of the sea. The remaining part of the poem I will explain you in the next video. Thank you for listening to my presentation. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you.